best every day, and I think that's what we did. I was always had a positive outlook on life. I had strong faith. I believed God was in control of my life, and we had great leadership. And this leadership that we had was so courageous that that's why I decided to write this book, not about me, but about the leaders.
Well, the name of the book is called Leading with Honor, Leadership Lessons from the Hanoi Hilton. So let's get into it. What did you learn spending time, 5 years in a prisoner of war camp?
Well, I think, first of all, I matured and learned a lot about courage. That, you know, courage was, I was a pretty courageous person, I thought. You know, I didn't feel like I had a lot of fears. But when you're facing an enemy that you're depending on for your very life to feed you and keep you, you know, a roof over your head, and also at the same time you're resisting their exploitation, they're trying to get you to do things against your country, well, that made it tough. So I developed a philosophy of lean into the pain of your fear to do what you know you ought to do, and that's been very helpful to me ever since. I think overall, learning to know yourself, getting to know yourself and both strengths and struggles, strengths and weaknesses, you might say, was very important for me. But also just how much courage it takes to be a leader and how much humility pays off. Our leaders are very humble. There were no pretense to them. They're very authentic. So that was very powerful.
So how do you take those experiences? And, of course, you've written a book about it. But then, you know, you speak. You speak all over the country, and you speak about leadership. How do you translate that into, you know, whether it be a hospital environment or a business setting or, gosh, right. You know, how do you do that?
Well, I have 14 lessons in the book, and they're really life lessons, but they're really more than that. They're leadership lessons. And the first six are about knowing yourself. Know yourself, guard your character, stay positive, confront your doubts and fears, fight to win, and bounce back. Be resilient. The one that I focused on a lot lately is clarify the culture, over-communicate the message, develop your people, and balance mission and people. Because you have to clarify the culture. All good organizations have a great culture. I think Rex demonstrates that in your community and especially within their own organization. And you have to work at over-communicating the message, you know, over and over, being repetitive and through numerous channels. And then balancing mission and people, you know, most everybody comes wired up to either be good with people and not so good at getting results, or real good at getting results and not so good with people. So you kind of have to be a good leader, you have to learn to balance that up a little bit. So you have to learn some things that you didn't know before, and that sometimes gets to be difficult to do.
Oh, no question about it. And for people who are listening, who may not be in a position today where they're leading a whole lot of anybody, well, what advice do you have for them? Because we all aspire to be that at some point in life, but, you know, just living life sometimes can be very, very hard.
Right. Well, first of all, you'd be surprised how much, even when you have no position of leadership, you'd be amazed how much influence you have over people that are watching you to see how you respond. I learned that about a year after I got home from the POW camps, because I was a junior ranking guy and the youngest guy in the camp in most every camp I lived in. I was a first lieutenant and a fairly new first lieutenant. But when I came home and they wrote, for the first time ever, performance reports on all of us. And then I got promoted 6 months after I got back, 2 years early, to the rank of major. And when I went back and read my performance reports, evidently I'd had a lot more influence on my leaders than I knew. So that told me something. And then I think the most important thing, regardless of whether you're in a leadership position or not, is just to be authentic. Be yourself. Believe in yourself. You know, don't worry about your uniqueness and your the things that are about you that are not like others that you really admire, because there are a lot of things in you to admire. Focus on those and believe in yourself. And just go after what you're passionate about, and you're probably going to do well.
Yeah, wonderful advice. For folks who want to learn more, is it leadershipfreedom.com? Is that the best page? And where do they get their book? Is it available? It's got to be available everywhere, right?
Oh, yeah, it's available everywhere, all the online stores. It's in all the electronic books as well as an audio book. So you can get it anywhere. You should be able to. Most any bookstore will have it, but it is on the online bookstores. And we have quite a bit of information, pictures, and videos, as well as you can purchase the book at leadingwithhonor.com.
Perfect. Well, sir, what a pleasure. An honor to talk with you. Thank you for what you've done to the country and giving me some advice. I'm going to be a better person after talking to you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much. And you have a wonderful community there. I really enjoyed being there.
I appreciate it. Thank you very much. It is awesome here. Colonel Lee Ellis. And he is right. You know, sometimes we live in this little bubble. Well, I think we all do. Well, maybe it's just me, and I think we all do. But you forget that everything you do, everything you say, how you react does have impact on others. So you do have that that influence or, you know, leadership. So it was a pleasure to get the chance to speak with Colonel Lee Ellis. Now we have...